So here's all the pieces ready to go. Gonna get the rocket motors out of the way. The only thing that's not here is the actual holder for the rocket, the real rocket motor. On this base piece here, you'll notice flat areas where the rocket's actually attached to, and in the groove there's a little flat area too, so you can do precise aligning of this part. What I'm using here is a thin CA glue. That's my preference simply because I like how fast it sets, but you're welcome to use anything you prefer. Now let's slide the tube down the center of the rocket.
Future Rob here. Before you do this, make sure that both tubes are bonded together before you slide them in. You can't bond them later, and it'll make a soft little spot in the rocket, I found out.
Tube in the topmost piece and make sure the capsule can align flush. I had to pull this tube out and cut it after the fact. Now this is super important. This is where your launch rod goes. So you need to make sure that all of these are aligned so that your metal launch rod can slip right through there without any binding whatsoever before you glue them. This model is super simple to assemble. The parts simply interlock and slide over each other. And already it appears that I need a much wider camera view. Again, here I'm just going to test to make sure that I've got free fit of the launch rod. And here you're seeing the opening where the launch rod comes back out. So again, just make sure you have very free alignment. So here you see my mistake. Clearly there's a gap, and I'm having to fool around with this tube again. Had I slid them both, had started at the top and slid them down, this would have been much easier. I had already glued the topmost part of the capsule on here. And also the original print of this that was all one piece, and the escape assembly broke, so I'm having to reattach it here. You won't have to do that normally in the print been supplied. So that's it. Probably the easiest build I've ever done. Let's just move on to the motor and shoot. Estes model rocket engine mount kit. It's about $8. And inside, we have all these bits. We have tubes for rocket motors. We have reinforcements and retaining clips, and we have spacers, which unfortunately none of them fit. So we had to do this, make our own. I'll show you how. Yes, I know, a little bit overkill here, but you know, we had the tool, so why not use it? If you don't happen to have a $30,000 laser cutter, then use a pencil, trace, and cut with an X-Acto knife. Far cheaper solution, I think. Or if you happen to live in Dallas, then stop by the Triumph Workshop and look into a membership. Yeah, I don't own this thing. I just use it. How much better is that? So now I'm going to assemble
the rocket housing for the motor per the directions by adding the additional sleeves on it, adding the metal retainer pin, and of course, I'm going to CA glue it in place here. But don't forget right after this step to add the spacer that was custom size for the paper towel holder. And here you'll see me putting it on right here. Now this was the one that has the notch in it, and it needs that notch so that the little lever has room to lift up and release the rocket motor out. We'll glue that one in place, and then we'll focus on the next ones. So I want to point out here that this rocket ultimately ended up needing a little more oomph than this C-size motor. So this all still applies, there's plenty of space, but we really need to do an assembly for a D-sized motor for this rocket. You'll see me now putting on the forward retainer and spacer as well. So, and this forward one clamps over the little metal bracket so that it can kind of spring and snap back into place. And there I am bonding them with CA glue. So here's the test fit. The motor slides right in easily and snaps in place with that retainer clip. Looking good. Now let's test fit it inside the tube of the rocket body. Want to make sure that it slides free enough, but not too loosely. And this one looks like it's doing just fine. And now what you will do, take it back out and use white glue on the upper ring so that you have time to work with it, slide it into place, and then you can CA glue the bottom ring into place